You know how you love to hear what other people are up to? Maybe sometimes it stimulates ideas in your own mind. But it's always good to hear what other folks are doing and celebrate with them the things that are worth celebrating. And speaking of stimulating, the Presbytery gave out $1,000 stimulus checks to congregations based on the parable of the talents. And we've got some reports on how things have been going for folks. This comes in from Morrow Community Press, which passed on their $1,000 check, or their $1,000 gift, to the local grocery store, Huskies Market, that has been struggling lately. Huskies has supported the church and the community, they say, in a million ways, including providing sandwiches for all the people who go out to fight the wheat fires in the area.
Grace Presbyterian in Portland reported what a joy it was to plan how to use these funds, and they decided to use half to support minority-owned neighborhood businesses. They purchased gift cards at Bisson Coffee Shop to give to employees at Prescott Terrace, which provides help to those transitioning from homelessness. They bought lots of donuts from Annie's Donuts to give to essential workers at Port Haven Rehabilitation Center and the Portland Police North Precinct. And they provided food resources for two Hispanic families who had lost jobs.
First Presbyterian Church Astoria matched the $1,000 granted to us with a similar amount from undesignated memorial funds, and we gifted the $2,000 to the public health director to help underwrite tests and pay for those who can't. Finally, I put our story out on the email list of community pastors that I regularly keep, and I invited all of my colleagues to consider joining us in that effort.
We took the mission stimulus funds from Cascade Presbytery, and as a session, we decided to multiply them through our church and donate them to Mosaic Medical, which is a community health provider here in Central Oregon. Mosaic Medical serves the healthcare needs of 4,000 Redmond residents. That's in a town of only 30,000, primarily those who are uninsured or underinsured or utilizing Oregon Health Plan. Our session turned that $1,000 into $3,000, and our congregation matched that plus some more, totaling close to $7,000 that we'll be donating to Mosaic Medical, with half of that designated for mental health care needs for our neighbors who need it most here in Redmond.
Myrtle Point Presbyterian Church matched the $1,000 grant from the Presbytery to donate $2,000 to the Myrtle Point Food Bank.
In addition to your $1,000, Southminster has matched another $1,000 from our equity accounts to help address hunger issues in Washington County. The four organizations that we've chosen to receive $500 each are Meals on Wheels in Beaverton, Vos Elementary and Whitford Middle School, both receiving support to purchase food cards for families, and Adelante Mujeres, a nonprofit group based in Forest Grove, Oregon, and the donation will increase food vouchers given to Latino and Latinx families.
Hi, Presbytery of the Cascades. I'm Karen Hill, pastor of the First Presbyterian Church of Cottage Grove. I'm here at the Cottage Village, our tiny house, low-income housing project. I thank you for the $1,000 stimulus check. We had an anonymous church member who immediately matched it for $1,000. Our deacons threw in another $1,000, and then we donated it to Square One Villages. They matched that grant. So we are now ready, fully funded for 9 houses. They will be ready to go at the end of the summer. So thank you for helping us.
The Mission Committee of Brookings Presbyterian identified individuals and businesses in the community affected by the pandemic shutdowns. They gave each of them a check for $100. This planted the seed in their congregation, and they asked people to make similar gifts. To date, those gifts have totaled over $1,400, more than double the original gift.
The Mill City congregation challenged members and friends to match the Presbytery grant, resulting in an additional $1,400. The session voted to send $1,400 to support outreach to youth and their families through the Santiam Youth Services Team, and $1,000 to the hospital-based Santiam Service Integration Team, a partnership of schools, faith organizations, social service agencies, and law enforcement meeting local community needs.
At Mackenzie Valley in Walterville, the funds were donated to the Lower Mackenzie Community Resources Food Bank, which is run by their neighboring church, Mackenzie Bible Fellowship. And that has promoted a partnership between the two churches, allowing the small COVID-stressed church to be part of a larger effort to provide food to their community.
We wanted to double our Presbytery grant and found a partner, Food for Families. After the pandemic closed schools, our campaign was to fill the gap for 70% of local school-age kids who qualify for free and reduced lunch. Food for Families says thank you.
Food for Families is a nonprofit that was started by students in the Centennial School District, and we operate a food pantry out of a school bus. With Covenant Presbyterian's donation towards our organization, we were able to fund an entire summer of distributions, which is about five distributions, and we were able to serve about 3,000 people over the entire summer.
Chapel by the Sea in Lincoln City was spurred on to love through a contact with a woman who is also a member of the Navajo Nation, but serving in their community health department. Told of the desperate need for masks, church members went out, bought material, and began to sew. Not only did they provide 500 masks to the Navajo Nation, but they contributed another 500 masks to their closer neighbors, the Confederated Tribes of Siletz. Although through this effort, the congregation decided to use the $1,000 seed money to develop a closer relationship with those tribes. And so for them, the story continues.
Plymouth Church of St. Helens split the grant money three ways to serve people in the community who are suffering during this pandemic. They made gifts to SAFE, a women's domestic abuse center, the WIC program, providing support for women and children, and to Fostering Kids of Love, which provides backpacks of necessities for children who have been taken from their homes and are being placed in foster homes. The church was glad to be able, quote, to make a difference in the quality of life for a more fragile part of our population, unquote.
Community Press in Waldport has had a long-established feeding program in the community, which they've had to discontinue because of the pandemic. They pivoted and are providing breakfast takeout and food box program and will use the funds to continue that program for the long haul. Working with the community, they're able to purchase food from the food bank and have put together a volunteer team of people who are less susceptible to the virus.
Brett and the community of Pilgrims approached us once they received their stimulus grant and said, hey, wasn't there something about Jesus sending out people two by two? That is a picture of partnership. What if we put our funds with your funds and created something bigger? Two of them are mission partners of Moreland, Meals on Wheels. Their needs we've been highlighting for weeks now. Also, Ecumenical Ministries of Oregon and the Interfaith Movement for Immigrant and Refugee Justice, who helped to create the Oregon Worker Relief Fund. We also have two opportunities with newer partners. Street Roots, who many of us are familiar with. We hand out their booklets to people needing resources. The fourth opportunity is with Human Solutions, brought to us by Community of Pilgrims.
Our session was deeply grateful for the opportunity to use grant money that came, and we used that to seed a fund that we put together as a congregation called the Loaves and Fishes Fund. We invited members of the church to contribute from the government checks that went out and to grow that fund. And to date, we're close to $6,000 that have come in from our congregation. We've been able to use that to support agencies and organizations here in Clackamas County that are sort of on the front lines when it comes to addressing poverty.
Hi, everybody. I'm Pastor Rachel, and I'm here at my friend Helen's house. And you can see we have a whole bunch of work to do, which is going to take place this summer at Grandpa Grumpy's Life Skills Camp, offered for kids as a result of this quarantine and pandemic situation, and just bringing them life skills and adult mentoring and fun that they've lost so much of during this really difficult time for families. We're thankful for the grant. With it, we've been able to start work here and provide for an outreach coordinator, as well as build a new wheelchair ramp this summer for Helen and provide some safety and security for her. Thank you for this grant, and we're excited to see what God does through.
I'm Beth Neal, one of the pastors here at Westminster, and we were so pleased to receive the $1,000 from the Presbytery and to partner with Rose City Park Presbyterian on this mission grant challenge.
Hi, I'm Paulette Mixon-Weller, one of the pastors at Rose City Park Presbyterian Church, and we are so grateful for the $1,000 given by the Presbytery. With that money, we had a goal of raising $12,000, but our congregation raised $13,000.
Hi, Daniel Irons is our pantry assistant that we were able to hire on through the generosity of Rose City Presbyterian Church and Westminster Presbyterian Church. And we are so excited to have him help us while we are serving extraordinary numbers of people.
Westminster has had a long relationship with Genesis Community Fellowship, so we were very happy to be able to give them $5,000 for their food pantry thanks to this grant challenge.
I'm Elder Beth Outerson at Westminster Presbyterian Church. We gave $4,500 to Living Cully's Rental Assistance Program and $500 in gift cards to residents at Living Cully.
Woodburn First knew just who to turn to when invited to multiply their $1,000 grant for COVID relief. They partnered with Love, Inc. of North Marion County, which leverages every dollar they receive. Every dollar they receive, they leverage it to $26.51 of benefit through its community organization partnerships. The church was able to help several families with rental assistance and contributions toward utilities, to which we can all say, thanks be to God. Good seeing you.